On the 3D effects dialog box, we're looking at the illumination tab. We're going to start down here at the bottom with this preview window. We see a sphere in the preview window, so I'm going to add one to our slide. We can see the lighting on our sphere matches the lighting in the preview window. To change the positioning of our lighting, we have to move this light source. I'm going to grab it and drag it with the mouse, moving it to the other side. We see some scroll bars, but they don't seem to be working at this time with the version of LibreOffice that I'm using. To apply the light setting to our shape, we need to go up and click on Assign. And we see it applies it to our shape. Now that works well with the sphere, but what happens if I add a cube to our screen? Well, the light setting looks the same. If I move it to the other side, click Assign, it does work. But we can also change our sphere in our preview window to a cube. To do that, I'm going to click on this lower right-hand corner of the preview window. The angle in our preview box doesn't match the angle on our slide. And just to mix things up a little, I'm going to rotate this one just a little bit. Now I'm going to try and match the cube in my preview window to match my slide. To do that, I'm going to click on the cube in the preview window. We'll notice that the frame for our light source has disappeared, and now our scroll bars work. We don't need to use them. I can just grab the shape and rotate it, but I can also use my scroll bars. So I'm going to try and match up what I have on my slide. And that's pretty close. Now to go back to adjusting the light source, I can either click on the light source itself here or on the lit up light source in the upper left hand corner. Again, I can adjust this by grabbing it and moving it, or I can use our scroll bars. These now are functional. And to apply it to my object, I'm going to click Assign. To review, we can change the shape in our preview window to a sphere or a cube by clicking the lower right-hand corner. And to change the rotation of the shape in the cube, we click on the cube itself. And here we can either drag the shape itself or from the scroll bars. To go back to the light source, we can click on that light source. And to rotate the light source around the object, we can move it with our mouse by dragging and dropping or by using the scroll bars, but they only work after we've clicked on the object to rotate it. There are three different sources of color for our 3D object. We've got the color of the object itself, we've got an ambient light, and the color of the light source. Let's start with our light source. First thing I want to do is select my object. I can select the color of the light source from this drop-down. We'll choose red and applying that makes our whole object look purple because it's a blue object with a red light, and blue and red make purple. To change that, I can change the color of the object itself. Let's make it white. Now the red shows up a little better. If I don't like the colors in the drop-down, I can always click the colors dialog box. If I know the numbers of the color I want, I can just type those in, or I can drag up and down the slider and then move our circle to the color that I want. I'm going to cancel out and leave it at red, but I'm going to move it down a little bit more so it shines on one side of our torus a little more than the other. The last color we have is this ambient light. The ambient light for LibreOffice is a constant indirect light that will help define the 3D object. The default is gray. When we changed the color of the shape to white, our red really stood out. Using the same logic, if we change our ambient light to white, we would think that that red would stand out even more. So I'm going to change that to white. And when I click assign, we see that our shape is now unrecognizable as a 3D shape. So having a white color and a white ambient light really does not work for us. I'm going to change this back to a gray, maybe 20%. And we can see that it does lighten things up a lot more, so our red is not quite as intense as it was. Depending on the effect you're trying to achieve, sometimes a lighter ambient light or a darker ambient light will play a difference. Now we're going to look at our light source. We've got 8 different lights here to choose from. I'm going to add a second light. To do that, I'm going to select it by clicking on it. Now that it's selected, I need to click it again to turn it on. This light is default sourced black, right in the middle. I'm going to move this down and to the left, and I'm going to change the color to blue. Clicking assign, now we see blue on the left and red on the right. Now if I click it again, I turn it off. Because I've selected it, now if I click it, it'll just toggle on and off, on and off. I'll leave it on. Now I don't have to go in direct order. I'm going to come down and click on light source 7. I've just clicked on it, so I can't change the color yet. I need to click it a second time to turn it on. Now I'm going to change it to white. And I'm going to move this up and to the left. Clicking assign, we see it really washes out everything. White's a bit too bright, so I am going to change that to a gray, maybe 60%. It's a little darker. I may even want to take that up a little bit more, 70%. Clicking back on the first light, we have that light source selected. Now, instead of clicking on the light source itself, I can come right down to our preview window and select the light sources from here. Selecting the blue one, I'm selecting the red one, and now the gray. Now, with that selected, I can move it around. Just as I do by clicking on light source, and there it was already selected, so it toggled it off. I need to click it again to turn it back on. So if I want to turn off the red light source, which was 1, I need to click it to select it. Now I can click it again to toggle it off and click it again to turn it back on. And we have 8 different light sources. We can turn them all on independently. The color of our ambient light, that one's going to be constant for all of the light sources because that's on the entire object, just like the color of our 3D shape. So the colors are affected by the color of the shape itself, the color of our ambient light, as well as the color of our light sources.